In this video from ITFreeTraining, I will look at some group policy tools that can be used for troubleshooting group policy and testing new settings. These tools include group policy results, group policy modeling, and GP result. Determining which settings have been applied on a client computer can be a tricky process. It is not always a simple matter to look at what settings have been configured in group policy to determine which settings will ultimately be applied. When group policy is applied, settings may not be applied due to factors like security settings and WMI filters. When trying to determine the end result a user or computer would receive from group policy, you essentially want to find the net effect of the group policy. This is known as the resultant set of policy, or RSOP. The group policy results tools that I will look at rely on this data in order to determine which settings are being applied. In order to run these tools, you need to meet a few requirements. First, you need administrator rights on the computer. The computer must be running Windows XP or above. If you are planning on connecting to the computer from remote, the computer requires port 135 and port 445 to be opened and the WMI service to be running. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 R2 domain controller to look at how to use some of these tools. First of all, I will open Group Policy Management from the Start menu. The first feature that I will look at is Group Policy Results. This will allow me to see what settings will be applied, even if WMI filters and security have been configured. To start the wizard, right-click on Group Policy Results and select Group Policy Results Wizard. Once you are past the welcome screen, the next screen will ask which computer you want to display the group policy results on. In this case, I will select a remote computer rather than the local computer. Notice that there is also a tick box which will only generate results for user configuration. This speeds up the process if you only require user settings. Notice that when I press Next, I get an error message telling me the RPC server is unavailable. This is because the other computer has not yet been configured to allow the connection. I will now change to my Windows 8 client computer to configure it for use with group policy results. On my Windows 8 client, I will first open the control panel. To do this, I will open Windows Charms by moving my mouse to the top right-hand corner, selecting Settings at the bottom, and then selecting Control Panel at the top. Once the control panel is open, I will use the search option to search the control panel for services. I will then select the option View Local Services to open the services control panel. The service that I want to start is called WMI Performance Adapter. Once I have the WMI service selected, I will open the properties for it. In this case, I will change the startup to Automatic Delayed Start. When the computer starts up, services configured as automatic will start first. Services configured for delayed start will start shortly after the computer has finished booting. This helps lessen the load on the computer when it first starts up, making it more responsive. Non-essential services should be configured for delayed start, while essential services should be configured to automatic. This option will not take effect until the computer is rebooted, so I will press the button Start to start the service up now. Now that the service has been configured, I will close services and go back to the control panel. I next need to make changes to the Windows firewall, so I will enter in Firewall in the control panel search and select the option Windows Firewall. In this case, I cannot configure the ports that I need opened in the standard interface, so I will select the option on the right, Advanced Settings. To configure the four rules required, select the option on the left, Inbound Rules. The first three rules that I need to enable are found under Remote Log Management. Before enabling the rule, check to make sure the profile is the one you want. In this case, the profile that I want is the domain profile, so I have the rule that I want to select. To enable it, right-click on it and select Enable Rule. I next need to enable the other two, remote event log management, ensuring that I select the ones that are for the domain profile. Once these three rules are enabled, the last rule that I need to enable is Windows Management Instrumentation. There are a few different rules for Windows Management Instrumentation, but the only one that you require is the one ending in WMIN. Now that I have configured all the rules, I can close the Windows Firewall and the Control Panel. Now that the client is configured, I will change back to my domain controller. Once I acknowledge the error and press Next, notice the wizard will now be able to communicate with the client and thus will continue. On the next screen, I can choose which user will be used to generate the user results. In order for a user to appear here, that user needs to have logged into the computer at least once. However, they do not need to be logged in when you run the wizard. Notice at the bottom, you have the option to disable user configuration and only generate results from computer settings. This will speed up the process if you only need to look at computer settings. The next screen on the wizard will show you the settings that were selected. Once I press Next, I will be able to press Finish and finish the wizard. Notice the results have been generated. At the top is the computer configuration, and at the bottom, the user configuration. If I expand General, notice that the computer name, domain, site, and last group policy processing time are listed. Under Group Policy Objects, you will notice that this lists which GPOs were applied and which were denied. Under the Applied GPOs, notice that the default domain policy is listed and the New York policy is listed. Under Denied GPOs, notice the local group policy has been denied. This may seem strange that it was denied until you see the reason that it was denied was because the local group policy is empty and thus there was no point applying it. Under Security Group Membership, when group policy was applied to the client, this shows which group the computer account was a member of when the report was generated. This is useful information if you find that a particular group policy has not been applied. The reason may be as simple as the user or computer is not a member of the correct group. If you have any WMI filters, they will be listed here. In this case, no WMI filters were applied. Lastly, you can see which components were used with group policy. If I select the Settings tab, this will list the individual group policy settings that would be applied. If I expand down into Administrative Templates, notice I can see that two settings were applied from the default domain policy. The benefit of using this method to view the settings is that it takes into account WMI filter and security filtering, and thus gives you a true indication of which settings were applied to that client. The last tab is Policy Events. This shows any group policy related events. You will notice that the event at the top states that group policy was successfully applied, which is what you want. If I scroll down to the bottom, notice that a warning event was generated. If I open the event, it is stating that software could not be installed as it required a foreground refresh. This kind of error is generally fixed by rebooting the computer and allowing group policy to be reapplied at system startup. If you are not sure what the error means, you can always perform an internet search on the event ID shown here. If you cannot find information on the particular event ID, try combining the search with part of the text from the description. If I go back now and open the error event above this, this particular event indicates an install problem. It is indicating a file could not be found, so it is most likely the computer could not access the install files when it attempted to install the application. Perhaps there was a permission problem, or the file server was not available. I will now close out of here and look at the next feature, Group Policy Modeling. Once again, all you need to do is right-click Group Policy Modeling and select the option Group Policy Modeling Wizard. Once I go past the welcome screen, the next screen will ask which domain controller you wish to connect to. you can choose any domain controller that is above Windows Server 2003. Windows Server 2003 adds additional features in order to support group policy modeling. The client could use a Windows Server 2000 domain controller to log in without issue. The feature is only required for modeling, or, to think of it another way, to run this wizard required Windows Server 2003 domain controller. On the next screen, you can select which container or user you want to perform the modeling with. In this case, I will select the user Trainer and the computer WS4. Both the user and computer account are located under the OU New York. On the next screen, I can choose some additional simulation options. At the top, I can choose to enable slow network connection. This means the group policy setting will be processed as if the computer detected a slow network connection. The next option allows you to configure loopback processing. If you are thinking about using loopback processing, it is a good idea to test the configuration out in group policy modeling before you configure it in case there are any potential problems. Below this, you can choose the site that will be used. If you have users that travel, this is a good way to test the site-related group policies and correct any problems before the user leaves the office. In this case, I will choose the Washington site and move on. On the next screen, you can choose where you want the simulation to consider the user and computer account to be located. In this case, the user and computer accounts are located under the New York OU. However, in this example, I will choose the Washington Users and Computers OU. This will allow me to test what would happen if the user and computer account were moved in Active Directory without having to move the accounts around. On the next screen, I can choose which security group the user is a member of. This is useful to test out group changes if you are using security filtering. Once again, this is done without changing or modifying the user. The next screen is very similar to the last, but this time you can select a security group for the computer account. In this case, I do not want to test any group changes, so I will press Next and move on. On the next screen, you can configure which WMI filters will be used for the user. If I select only these filters, I can select which filters to use. In this case, there are no WMI filters being used on these group policies, so I cannot select any. On the next screen, you have the same options for WMI filters, except these apply to computer configuration. I'm not using any WMI filters, so I will move on. The next screen will provide a summary of the options I choose. Once I press Next, I will be taken to the Finish screen of the wizard. Now that the wizard has completed, notice that a report has been generated with all the settings in it. If I expand the General section, notice that the computer name has come up as WS4, which is currently located in New York. However, since I changed the location of the computer account in the wizard, the report has been generated as if the computer was in the Washington Computers OU. This tab only gives general information. If I select the Settings tab, I can see the settings that would be applied if the user and computer accounts were moved to Washington. All this is done without making any changes to group policy or Active Directory. You can see that if I expand the administrative templates, I can see that only two settings have been applied from the default domain policy. No group policy settings have been configured for Washington. Before I move the user and computer accounts, I should consider configuring some group policy settings and applying these to Washington. Once this is done, I should rerun this wizard to see if this is the result I want before moving the user and computer accounts from New York. The last tab, Query, shows the settings that were used to generate the report. I can also achieve similar results from the command line. To look at how to do this, I will change to my Windows 8 client. From Windows 8, I will first open the search option. From here, I will go down to the command prompt icon and right-click it. Right-clicking the icon will display additional options at the bottom of the screen. The option that I'm interested in is Run as Administrator. Once I have a command prompt open with administrator rights, the first command that I will run is gpresult with the /r switch. The /r switch displays a summary of the resultant set of policy data, or RSOP data. This is the same information that I was able to obtain using the Group Policy Result tool in Group Policy Management Console that I demonstrated earlier. For this command and other commands that I will demonstrate in this video, I will add a broken bar followed by more to the command line. This tells Windows to transfer the output from one command to another and is a process called piping. The more command will take the output from the first command and pause the screen when it is full, making it easier to read. You can see that the /r switch gives you basic information about the group policies that were applied to this computer. For basic troubleshooting, it is a fast way to determine which group policies have been applied, which OU the user and computer account is in, and which settings, such as slow link, have been enabled. If you want additional information, you can use the /v switch for verbose mode. In this case, I have added the /scope switch with the user option to limit output to user configuration only. If I did not add the scope switch, the amount of data given would be quite large. I can also use the scope option to limit the output to computer configuration only. You will notice that toward the end is additional information that was not shown with the /r switch. However, the start of the output is pretty much the same. If you prefer the output to be in a report format, you can output the results to an HTML or XML file using the /h or /x switches. In this case, I will output the report into HTML format. Once complete, notice that when I open the report using Internet Explorer, the report is the same report that I viewed earlier using Group Policy Management Console. You can see that using gpresult, you can achieve the same results as using Group Policy Results in the Group Policy Management Console. You can see that using these tools will not only help you troubleshoot group policy related problems in your domain, but will also help you implement new group policy changes. Thanks for watching this video from IT Free Training. If you'd like to see more videos from us, please subscribe to us on YouTube. See you next time.